Hello, everybody, and welcome to the first Whip It Up Wednesdays segment. This is going to be something that I'll start doing every Wednesday. And so if there's something you want me to make or something that you want us to learn to make together, then just let me know in the comments below, and that's something that we'll work on. Today we're going to be making our conditioner that's a goat milk and fermented rice water conditioner. And I do make this a lot, and it's one of my biggest sellers. So I have already measured out in my bowl the amount that I need of the rice water and goat milk. And I will warm this so that it's not really cold when it goes into the melted mixture. So in this bowl, I have mango butter and then some other oils that I like to use that are really good for your hair. And in this container, I've measured out my seal alcohol, my steric acid, and my e-wax, as well as some BTMS 50. I'm going to pour this into the butters and the oil and melt it all together. My hands are clean. I don't wear gloves a lot because my hands are small, but I do use hand sanitizer in the soap room. I also use my apron constantly as a hand cloth because it's just right there, and I'll take it off and throw it in. I have many aprons. So anyway, I'm melting down the oils and butters. And in this jar, I have measured out my essential oil blend. And in this jar is my preservative because it's a goat milk and rice water conditioner. It's a liquid conditioner. Well, not liquid, but not a solid conditioner. You have to use a preservative. And in this container, I have pre-measured out some liquid silk that I will be adding to the conditioner. So I'm going to tell you everything that I put in the conditioner, but I am not giving you my quantities, my ratios, because this is a conditioner that I make and I sell. So therefore, I'm just not going to give you out all of the details, just the important ones, because then you can change it up. Now, I didn't give you the liquid oils that I had in my container, what I choose to use. I think that should be a personal preference to what you like. Even the mango butter, I always use the mango butter, but you could use shea butter, you could use some cocoa butter. You know, there's lots of kokum butter, there's lots of butters that you can use, and that would be, again, a personal preference to what you like when you make your conditioner. So I am using a new camera today, and I have a new camera, I have a new computer that has new editing material on it, so I'm going to be learning this whole way. This is going to be a learning curve first in this series.
Dining room door.
So, I have a grandchild coming in the background. I hear him coming in. But anyway, so I'm going to end up moving my tripod over to the countertop where the mixer is so that you can see me mixing, because everything is new and I just, today's playing around with how to get things done. And once I make this video, I'll know what I'll need to change in the future for future videos. So I'm just going to move my mixer to the side on this table, and that way I have a place to set the tripod when it's ready to go over there. So I'm checking my recipe. I have it hanging on the wall, so I check it from time to time to make sure that I have everything that I need. And I do. So I brought you over to the table where we're going to be mixing everything up. Now that everything's melted, I have my goat milk and rice water warm. And I do that because you don't want to pour anything cold into a melted bowl of like things with steric acid and e-wax. They set up really fast. So I'm going to go ahead and pour my melted butters and oils into the mixer. And yes, you see where it turns white around the edges. It's because the mixer is cooler than the oils are, so that's okay. I'll scrape that back down as we're working, and it will melt back into everything. So it's okay. go ahead and get the beater on. And then I'm going to turn it on low and slowly mix in the rice water and milk portion. This whole process takes, maybe 20 minutes from start to finish. So I will pause from time to time until it's at a point that, you can see something, the transformation of it. That's a good word, transformation. I know you can see little specks of things flying because I can too, but it's liquid and that's just to be expected. Now it's getting thicker, so it's about time to start adding the other additives. See my specks on my floor behind you on the, I can see them on the camera. My floor is clean. It does have some oil stains from spilling, but I do shampoo it. Okay, so we've just added our liquid silk, and we'll get that completely mixed in. Silk helps strengthen your hair, so that's a really good thing to have in there. And it doesn't take a lot. So I'll let that combine for just a little while. And I don't know if you notice when I make, look at that flying out. And no, this is not big enough, and it just shot me right on the cheek, so I had to wipe my cheek off. But anyway, I'm using a step stool to step up onto so I can see down in the bowl because I'm only 4'11", and my countertop that the mixer sits on is about 4 foot high, so it makes it hard for me to see down in the bowl without using the step stool. So I'm just going to get the sides scraped down so I make sure everything is all mixed together well. And I'm going to go just grab another spatula because it's just easier to clean the spatula off with a second spatula. That way I don't have to use the side of the bowl to keep scraping everything off. And I have to keep scraping it back down in there. So I'll wipe off the side of the bowl. And I'm going to go ahead and add my essential oil blend. I use sweet orange, a little bit of Spanish rosemary, and some other things like that. You can use whatever you want to use when you make your own recipe. I use what I know has a good reputation for being good for your hair. The scent is very light, so you could use those things and then add fragrance oil to the conditioner if you wanted to at some point, if someone wanted a scented to match a particular shampoo. Or you could just not put any of those things in there and add them as needed. So I'm going to go ahead and continue mixing this for just a little while. Okay, it's looking good. I'm going to scrape the bowls down one more time, or the bowl down one more time. And make sure it's all mixed in really well. This is sort of a messy process. One of these days I'll have a bigger mixer and all that sort of thing. And a lotion filler. I would love to have an ocean filler. A lotion filler because I use, I can't talk today. I use a piping bag and that can be messy as well. It's okay the first round, but when you start adding more into it, it gets a little messy. Wipe off my hands really well. Get it started again. It's about time to add in the preservative, which I have right here. Go ahead and put this in. I'm going to drizzle it in slowly so it can mix completely in. Clean up some of my mess. Yes, I always soap or whatever in the soap room. I don't wear shoes in my house. As soon as I come inside, I kick them off in the laundry room, which is just right inside the doorway, because that's linoleum. So I just kick them off there and leave them there and slide them on when I go outside. So you're always going to see my bare feet, more than likely. So I'm going to get ready after I stir this down and make sure it's really good and mixed up. I'll end up taking you back over to the big table to finish up the process. Okay, so driving myself crazy with the mess. It's looking really good. I'm pretty sure it's about done, so that we can move over to the table and fill a bottle, just so I can show you how I fill my bottles. It's messy. It's going to be messy. So if you don't like messes, it might not be a good idea for you to watch this part. Just joking. But even I have a hard time with the mess that it makes, with the way that I do it anyway. So until I find a better solution, this is what I'm stuck with. I just clean up the mess. I'm grabbing a bottle. I had already started filling some bottles earlier because I had a lot of orders for the conditioner. And that's when I realized, well, I'm not going to have enough. So I'm going to just stop right now and make some more. So I'm going to use what I had already made up first and get that in the bottle. And then I will move on to this batch once it's completely cooled down. You can pour warm lotion in the bottle, but you really have to let it sit and cool down inside the bottle before you cap it, because you don't want to create condensation. This is the jar that I had been working out of. And this is what's left in the bag where I was working. So I'll scrape the rest of it out of the jar and put it in the bag. And go ahead and pipe it in the bottle. And these are the bottles that I use. I like these. I get these from the chemistry store. And they come with a turret top. But for the conditioner, I take those off and use a pump. I'll get a pump and show you. Whoops, first I need to hand sanitize. And this is why it gets messy. The bag already had some conditioner in it, so you know it's gonna get messy. And but it is what it is. But my hands are soft. Normally I put the bag down in a mason jar and let the mason jar hold the bag up while I fill it, but I moved it earlier and I took it out of the room to the sink to be washed, and I'm just not going to go grab it now. I'll just go ahead and continue on and just fill it this way. So using the mason jar does help it be a little less messy. Let me get a spatula and scrape some of that down into the bag better, so that it doesn't squeeze out the top. Wipe my hands. Okay, so now that way it won't squeeze out of the top of the bag. Just pop it in now, give it a good twist, and just squeeze it into the bottle. I do make sure that I pound the bottle on the table from time to time to get out any air pockets. And then I always weigh the bottles so that each customer has the same amount. Plus, that helps me know the right amount to get in there before I put the pump in. I forgot to show you the pump. Before I put the pump in, because it takes up space. So you're not putting a complete 8 ounces of conditioner in the bottle, because you have to save room for the pump. Let me grab that pump. I also get these from the chemistry store. Well, I am going to let this cool down before I put any more into my bottles, because what's already in the bottle is cool. I don't want to add any of the warm to it. But what I'll do is I'll let this set up and get cooled down, and then I'll add it to my bottle. And once I add it to the bottle, I will wash the bottle off with some rubbing alcohol to make sure that there's no residue from the conditioner on the outside of the bottle from my hands, so that the label will adhere to the bottle, because the bottle is already a smooth bottle. And so then I'll do that and put the pump in there, seal it up really tight, and slap that label on, and then ship it off. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please give me a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and I welcome any suggestions of a video to do. So that's what I have for today. It's goat milk and fermented rice water conditioner, and it's a great seller for me. I hope you give it a try for yourself, and watch for all the ingredients listed below, and I'll tell you where I've gotten them from. And that's all I have for today. Thanks for watching the first Whip It Up Wednesday. And so, bye for now.